Hello, this is your Congressman, Michael Burgess. Throughout our nation's history, Americans have proven time and again our willingness to defend our freedom when it is threatened. We have also used force when necessary to act against unjust brutality in the world. Last week, President Trump took action to launch precision strikes on targets associated with the chemical weapons capabilities of Syrian dictator Bashar al-Assad. Alongside our allies, France and the United Kingdom, the armed forces took calculated action to establish a strong deterrent against the production, spread, and use of chemical weapons. In the wake of Assad's regime's consistent heinous crimes against his own people, the president enforced for the second time the red line, established 5 years ago by the previous administration. Under Article 2 of the Constitution, President Trump has the authority as Commander-in-Chief to defend important United States national interests, especially the deterrence of chemical weapons. However, if President Trump wishes to continue military action in Syria, I do want him to come to Congress for authorization. I do believe that long-term action under the authorization for use of military force passed in 2001 is not the correct answer. In my time in Congress, I have never voted on an authorization to use military force despite prolonged military action abroad. Along with President Trump, I hope that we can bring our warriors in Syria home soon. With their action last Friday, America signaled to the world that we will not stand for the barbarism, we will not stand for the brutality that has occurred with the use of chemical weapons in Syria. As President Trump said, the nations of the world can be judged by the friends that they keep. No nation can succeed in the long run by promoting rogue states, brutal tyrants, and murderous dictators. Today and every day, we must remember the sacrifices in the service of our armed forces. At home and abroad, members of the armed forces put their service first, and we are indebted to them. As always, I appreciate your comments and your concerns on this issue or any other issue. May God bless you and your family. God bless our troops, and as the song says, God bless you, Texas.